Hello students, how are you all? I hope all of you have watched the NCERT solution of this chapter. Chapter number 3, how many squares? So this video is related to important topics or important concepts of the chapter which are not given in your textbook. Okay? So if you find something very important during this particular video or this lecture, you can write it down in your notebook. Okay? So let's start with the concept of perimeter. So as we have already learned, perimeter is nothing but total length of boundary. So what do you mean by that, total length of boundary? Let's take an example. If we take example of square, if I am drawing a square has how many sides? Four sides, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And all these four sides are equal. If we consider, if this side is of 3 cm, then all the other three sides are also of 3 cm. Okay? 3 cm, 3 cm. So if I tell you to find the perimeter of this square, what will be it? It will be the total length of boundary. So how to calculate the total length of boundary? If this is the boundary, we have to start from here, 3 cm, 3 cm, 3 cm, and 3 cm. So 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3, it has four sides, therefore 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3, it will be 12 cm. So the perimeter of this square will be 12 cm. We can write this 3 3 3 3. We have repeated addition. This is the repeated addition. We can write this in this way also, 3 into 4. There are 3 4 times, therefore we have write 3 into 4. So 3 into 4 also 12 cm. You can write in this way as well as in this way. This is repeated addition. Repeated addition. Okay? You can write in this way or in this way. In whichever way you are comfortable, you can write that. Okay? Let's check another example. If I take a square of 5 cm each, okay, which has sides 5 cm each. So we can find perimeter of that square by adding all the sides, that is adding 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5. 5 plus 5 10, 10 plus 5 15, 15 plus 5 20. 20 cm. Don't forget to write unit, okay? You have to write centimeter. If you are not writing the unit, your mark will be deducted, okay? So we can add the four side, or we can directly multiply this 5 with 4. That is 5 fours are 20 centimeter. Simple. So from this, we can say that perimeter of square is equal to 4 into length of side are you getting it 4 and 3 is nothing but length of this side. In this case also, 4 multiply by 4. So we are multiplying 4 with the length of the side, that is 5. So this is the formula for perimeter of square. You can simply add the all side, or you can directly apply this formula if you have to find perimeter of square. Is it simple? It's very simple. Okay students, as we have found the perimeter for square, we can also find the perimeter for rectangle. In that angle, the opposite sides are equal. If this side is of 4 cm, then its opposite side also of 4 cm. Same for 2 cm, then its opposite side will be of 2 cm. So let's calculate the perimeter. First way is to directly add the total of all sides. So 4 plus 4, 4 plus 4, plus 2 plus 2, plus 2 plus 2. Okay, we have added all 4 sides, that is total length of boundary. So if we add this, it will be 4 plus 4, 8 plus 2, 10 plus 2, 12. 12 centimeter. It is the simplest method. Or you can do, how many 4s are here? 2 4s. So 2 into 4. Is it clear? And how many 2s are here? 2. 2 into 2. It is also 2 4s are 8 plus 2 2s are 4, which is equal to 12. So again, this is the repeated addition and this is the multiplication. You can do it in any method, whichever you like. But you also know this method. It is very important, okay? So from this, we can say that perimeter of rectangle is equal to, you can directly calculate by adding the all sides, or you can use this formula, okay? 2 into length, 2 into 4, 4 is nothing but length, 2 into length plus 2 into, what is this 2? This 4 is of for length and this 2 is for breadth. So 2 into length plus 2 into breadth. Okay, it is simple. This is the formula for perimeter of rectangle, or in simplest method you can say that 2 into L, L stands for length, and 2 into breadth, B. Simple. This is the formula for perimeter of rectangle, or you can simply add the all sides. Okay students, so the student, next important topic is area. Area is nothing but total amount of space occupied by any closed figure. So if we consider this square as a closed figure, this square as a closed figure, then this space occupied by this closed figure is nothing but area. We have already seen. We have seen in our NCERT solution, we can simply calculate area by just calculating number of square, where each square is of side 1 cm. Okay? So, if each square is of 1 cm, then if we can simply calculate number of square, then we can find the area of this rectangle, which has length of 6 cm and breadth of 4 cm. So let's calculate how many square are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 2, 3, 4. 24 squares are there. So therefore area is equal to 24 square centimeter. This square centimeter is nothing but unit for area. Unit of area is square centimeter. Okay? So we can simply calculate area by calculating number of square. But there is another method. For rectangle, area of rectangle can be given as length. Length is how much? 6. Into breadth. Breadth is how much? 4. 6 into 4 is nothing but 24 square centimeter. Don't forget to write the unit, okay? So we can simply multiply length and breadth of rectangle and we can find the area of rectangle. Therefore, formula for area of rectangle is length into breadth. Simple. In the same way, if we want to calculate area of this square, which has each side of 4 cm, square has each side of 4 cm. We can simply calculate the number of square. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So we can say that the area of square is 16 square centimeter. Or in another way, we can simply multiply area of square is given as length into length. Length is 4 centimeter and another length is 4 centimeter. 4 into 4 will be 16 square centimeter. It is very simple. This is the formula for area of square and this is the formula for area of rectangle. You can write this formula in your notebook. Okay, you can simply calculate the number of square or you can directly apply this formula for square and rectangle. For rectangle it is length into breadth and for square it is length into length. Is it clear, student? It is very simple concepts. Based on these concepts, in standard 6 and 7, there are chapters on this concept. So, if anyone of you not able to understand any of this, please comment down below or message me. Okay? Now, students, let's study how to find area of triangle. Let's take a first example. In this example, this each box is of 1 centimeter. In all the other example, this 1 square is of how many centimeter? 1 centimeter. Just remember that. So if we take an example of this, if you can see, there are total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 16. 16 square centimeter of entire square I have made. And in that particular square, exactly half of the space is occupied by this triangle. Half of the space is occupied by this triangle. So half of this entire area will be area of this triangle. If the entire square has 16 square centimeter of area, I am talking about this entire square, out of which, if this is the triangle, you can see that this triangle is exactly half of this square. So the area of this triangle will be half of 16. So what is half of 16? Half of 16. 16. 8 to the 16. So 8 square centimeter will be area of this triangle. Again, this triangle occupies half of the area of this square. So the area of square is 16. So half of 16 will be 2 8s are 16. Simple. Let's take another example. It's very simple. Don't worry. In this example, we have two triangles. Look at this. First triangle is this. This is the first triangle. So this triangle occupies how much area? So for that, we have to just figure out how many square it occupies. If consider, let's take what is triangle. If this is the rectangle and if I do half of this rectangle, so okay, half of this rectangle is nothing but triangle. So if any triangles are given, you have to just figure out in which rectangle it is placed. So for this triangle, this is the rectangle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9. Total area of rectangle is 9 square centimeter. 9 square centimeter. So the half area is occupied by our triangle. Half of 9 will be 4.5. Okay? Don't worry. Let's take example of this triangle. This triangle occupies this rectangle. Okay? In this rectangle, half of this rectangle is this triangle. So for this square, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is the area of that square. So half of 4 is nothing but? Half of 4 is nothing but 2, 2 is a 4. 2 square centimeter. Are you getting, students? We have to just rectify its particular rectangle or square, and we have to just make half of that particular rectangle or square. Let's take a last example. It's very important. If you can see this big triangle, how can we now calculate the area of this triangle? For that, we have to divide this triangle into two halves. These two halves. For this rectangle, this is the one triangle, and for this rectangle, this is another triangle. So half, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20 square centimeter is the area of this rectangle. So half this triangle occupy half of this rectangle. So what will be the area of rectangle? Half of the, what will be the area of triangle? Half of the rectangle. So we have calculated what is the area of this rectangle? 20. And what is the half of 20? Half of 20. 2 tens are, okay, 10 square centimeter is the area of this half triangle. And what about this half? We have to first calculate area of rectangle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15, half of 15. It will be 7.5. You can divide and calculate. I know the answer because I am a maths teacher. Okay? So we have to just add 10 plus 7.5. If we add 10 plus 7.5, it will be 17.5 square centimeter. So the area of entire triangle is 17.5 square centimeter. Okay, we have first calculated this triangle, and after that we have calculated area of this triangle. In this way, we can calculate the area of triangles. Okay, triangle is nothing but half of entire rectangle. So, if we can find the area of rectangle, we have to just divide the entire area of rectangle by 2. And then we can get the answer of triangle. It's very simple. We have already seen in our NCERT solution. Isn't it? Okay? Okay, students, now let's study how to calculate area of irregular shape. We have already seen how to calculate area of square, area of rectangle, and area of triangle. Now we will learn how to calculate area of any irregular shape. You have to just follow these rules. Okay? What are these rules? Let's see. If your shape covers entire square, these are the squares, square of 1 centimeter each. So, if your particular shape cover entire square, then we have to consider it as 1 centimeter. Let's see in this particular shape, how many entire squares are there. So, this one entire square, this second is an entire square, third and fourth. Four entire square, that means 4 into 1, 4 centimeter. Okay, second, if your shape cover exactly half of your square, then we have to consider it as half centimeter. So let's see, there are any half square are there? Yes, this is one which exactly half, this is another which is exactly half, this is a this is like this. So this is not half. Okay? So there are two. Two half means if we add half plus half, what it will become? One. So two half is one. Now, if your shape cover more than half square, there are many times when your shape cover more than half of the square. then we have to consider it as 1 centimeter. Let's see, is there any squares or any shapes which are more than half? This is not more than half. This is more than half. This one is more than half. This one is also more than a half. Okay, that's it. There are 1, 2, 3 square which are more than half, and which are more than half we have to consider it as 1 centimeter. So 1, 2, and 3 plus 3 centimeter. And finally, if your shape cover less than half, then we have to neglect that square. Okay, if your shape covers less than half of the square, then we have to neglect that square. So in our case, this is one which covers less than half, this is the one which covers less than half, this is the one which covers less than half, and finally this is the one which covers less than half. We have to neglect this. So if we add 1, 4 plus 1 plus 3, that is 8 square centimeter. Symbol, our area of this shape is 8 square centimeter. Is it simple? We have to just remember this particular rules. If it covers entire square, then we have to consider it as 1 centimeter. If it cover half of the square, then we have to consider 1/2 centimeter. If it cover more than half of the square, then we have to consider it as 1 centimeter. And then finally, if it cover less than half square, then we have to neglect that particular square. And finally, we have to just add number of square together and we get area of that particular irregular shape. I hope, student, you all have learned these important topics, and if still any one of you has any doubt, please comment below or please message me. With this, we have completed our third chapter, which is how many squares. And if still you don't understand any topic, please rewatch the videos, previous videos, NCERT solution, as well as the explanation video. Okay? I hope you have liked the video. Take care.